Buenas tardes. No hay muchas personas porque autobús vamos a cocktail. Me llamo Stephen Ramrup. I am the head of the disaster office in Trinidad. Yo soy un cirujano ortopedista. Si, el programa en Trinidad, very importante, es comunidades organizadas y listos para las emergencias. Sí, tengo un problema en Trinidad muy difícil for disaster risk reduction, muy difícil. So, ¿qué es un problema? And ¿qué es CORE? CORE, Communities Organized and Ready for Emergencies. CORE, ¿qué es CORE? CORE es una marca, una herramienta y una metodología que solve mi problema. ¿Qué es mi problema? Quiero contar una broma para que pueda entender mejor. Tengo un amigo que fue a un doctor specialist, ¿no? Oído, nariz y garganta, ¿sí? Yes. Y se quejó de que su esposa era sordo, muy sordo, ¿no? No sé. Para que el médico le dijo que ir a casa y llamar a su esposa 5 metros, 10 metros y 15 metros de alto. Así que su fue a casa y llamó a su esposa de 15 metros, and he said, Lamiel, ¿puedes oírme? Ella no lo oyó. Él repitió esta 10 metros y lo mismo otra vez. Ella no lo oyó. Se fue a las 2 metros y una la llamó. Ella entonces dijo, tonto, te he estado contestando todo el tiempo, no me oyes, es sordo. Resulta que él era sordo, por lo que es la perspectiva de lo que importa, que realmente impulsa el DRR. It's not that I am deaf, it is the personas in the communities are deaf, because my responsibility is to mainstream disaster risk reduction, but it is their responsibility in the real sense. Por favor, understood? ¿Entiendes? So, CORE es todas las personas, politicians, NGOs, CBOs, and faith-based organizations, a National Disaster Office. Vamos a los pueblos todas las semanas y en el año hay 20 y 30 visits to los pueblos con muchas personas. Y cuando vamos a pueblos es importante cinco cosas. Agua y saneamiento, vivienda, shelter, nutrición y acceso a la salud y a la seguridad. Cinco cosas. Very simple. Todas las personas vamos a los pueblos muchos tiempos del año y cinco cosas. And it's been very, very successful. No tengo un video porque internet is very slow, pero if you go on ODPM official YouTube, their videos are on that link. ODPM official. Mi English, my hablo inglés muy mal, and hablo español muy mal, so perdóneme. Muchas escuelas en el program de CO, hay muchas escuelas. And it's in the middle of the photograph. And very important también, volunteers. Volunteers is muy importante cuando disaster muy larga. Porque my own employees, not possible. It happened in Philippines, for example, when your own office people did not come out to work. So volunteers, extremely important from the communities. And it has been a success. También. So, 5 minutos for my presentation. 5 cosas muy importantes. Water and sanitation. Shelter. Access to healthcare. Nutrition and security. Most important is understanding that it is not just your problem, it is their problem. And it is trying to get them to understand, that is the communities, that they are the ones to become resilient. As the National Disaster Office, we can be as resilient as we want. We can have all the oil and energy in Trinidad and Tobago as we want. But we are a small island state, and we are very vulnerable, and the resilience is really at the level of the people. So communities organized and ready for emergencies is core, and core focuses on the person. We are running our National Disaster Office as a business. We have a strategic plan. There are 3 pillars in that plan. One is legislative authority. The second one is 100% achievement of risk reduction, and the third is 100% achievement of readiness. Those 3 pillars are aligned to the Hyogo pillars, the SIDIMA comprehensive disaster management pillars that was there before the Hyogo priorities, and as well as the government pillars and the national security, because we fall under the national security ministry, for those of you all who understand. Our currency that we use is business continuity management. We use it as a tool, and we go there to all agencies, private, public, and the communities. And our bottom line is resilience. That's the business. So basically, we run it like a business, and all the programs are aligned to that, and we have scorecards and metrics that feed back to our vision and mission as the National Disaster Office. So what I'm really telling you here is a concept that we're using in small island states, for example, to see if we run the management of disaster risk reduction and climate change as a business, with the bottom line gain as resiliency, and we use engagement as our currency, and we use business continuity management as one of our tools. CORE has given us extreme value added based on the scorecards that we have gotten from the community in the number of metrics or core indicators that we have used to assess readiness and risk reduction and legislative authority in Trinidad and Tobago. So thank you very much for those of you who stayed back to listen. Pardon me for my English and my Spanish, but as I said, it is really the perspective. It's not what you want to hear sometimes, it's what the people tell you. And The guy was the deaf one. It wasn't his wife. He thought it was his wife, but he was the deaf one. And that is the problem that we have at the level, at the head level, of which I am. And it's a problem that we always have, because sometimes we really think we have all the answers when we don't. And that is the lesson of CORE. Muy bien. Buenas noches.